Hey guys, in this 3DVista tutorial I want to talk about the photo albums and how you can use this. To start the photo album, you go to photo album, list, and then you add album. So add album, you select the photos you want, you open it, and you click preview to see that it's not going to work. And now I'm going to tell you why it's not working. So in the publish settings, we can see that the photo album is selected lastly in the whole thing. So we move this all the way to the front, click preview again to see that it is working or not. What do you think? I think it is. So it's working. So you might say, okay, Ronald, it's nice that it's working, but this is not really the way I want it. I want to make it show in a pop-up. And I want to trigger this photo album through an action on a hotspot in a panorama. So how do you do this? Well, nice that you're asking. So to do this, we are going to the skin, to I'm gonna search, type in photo, and we can select one of these photo albums. So let's say the first one, the third actually. And we just click anywhere in the main viewer and make sure if you have already containers in there that it's not going to place them within the container. But yeah, so we put it in here. Now the photo album is there. And as you can see right away, viewer photo album one. This is an important thing because right now if I preview this, it's not going to show anything within this viewer or this photo album pop-up. And that is because this viewer needs to be selected in the photo albums. So I'm just going to show you quickly here. So here you can see viewer photo album one. So right now we are going to photo albums, photo album. And then we click see in viewer, not main viewer, but viewer photo album one. We're going to preview it and it's still not going to work. Damn, it is working. So sometimes it is working and sometimes it's not working. Now, I don't know exactly why, but if it's not working, then what you have to do is you go to skin, you click on anything that's going to pop up. I usually use the viewer, but it could also be the photo album container or whatever. And I say viewer photo album, if this is going to show up, then open album and open album image and say on show viewer photo album one, done. And so this is always working. So as you can see, we can navigate through, we can close it and we can just go like this. Now let's say we want to add the photo album to the couch. So what we will be doing is we go to panoramas. Now first we are going to disable the view, so it will not be triggered up in default. Now we go to one of these couches, then what we will be doing is we select one of these couches. Something like this, very quick. We say add action, show height components, photo album. We say on click, show this photo album, done. Now, instead of having the photo album opening up over on this viewer, we can also just remove this. I know this is a bit confusing. I will explain you later on why. That's because we are going to add the same action we just removed on here now. So open album here. On click in the open this photo album in viewer photo album one. Done. The reason I'm separating it from the skin viewer action to the polygon action right now is because I want to have multiple photo albums later on after this. So right now, on click of this couch, show the component and open the photo album. Preview. So we go to the couch right over here, click on it, and it shows the photo album. Now, let's say we want to add the second photo album. What we will be doing is we go to photo albums, add media, create photo album, select the photo, and we call this album 2. Now, what we will be doing is we go back to the panoramas. We first check the viewers. So viewer photo album 1 is selected here. But on this one, it's still selected on the main viewer. So change that. Now, what we'll be doing is we go to panoramas, reception, hotspots. And let's add this polygon hotspot to the second couch. So there we go, this one. Now we don't have to click here, 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 and then another one here, here, here. We can just go from here directly to there, and it will automatically change the whole thing. Oh. Ah, well, you can see it's like this. Now on this thing, we are going to add action, show hide components, the photo album again. So exactly the same, show photo album, done. So basically we could copy paste this one. Now add action, open album, album 2, on click in the open album 2 in viewer photo album 1, done. And now say preview. We go here, and as you can see, the hotspots are just showing up nicely, even though the panorama is cut off on that area. Well, it's been done very quickly. So we click on one of the couches, and this shows still photo album 1. And now this one is for 2. Well, it's only one photo, so there's nothing to go through. But as you can see, it opens the second photo album. We go back to 1, it shows 1. We go back to 2, it shows 2. And the nice thing about this is that the photo album is dynamically. So that means that when I change the color of this button in the skin, right over here, skin, photo album, I'm going to replace these images, for example, then it will be changed also over photo album 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and so forth. So this way, the photo album is dynamically, which is really nice. So let's go through the actions that you can do in the photo album. The first thing is it says include into carousel. So that means if I check this off, right now it's showing here. So I check this off and it will not show in this list anymore. So in the preview, it will not show the first thing, but it will still be available through actions to show up. Now, so I keep this the way it is. Stop global music when it plays. That means that when you have background audio working, so in the publish playlist background music, add audio, it will stop playing. Play as loop. That means that when this photo is being reached, it will go back to the first photo in here. Then change background color. This means that, let's see what it means. Change background color will do this. So as you see the screen, whoosh, you might want to change this to white, which is the default setting, which is usually the good thing. Or just remove it at all. Then you can fill in a title and a subtitle. This will show up if you use, instead of the any other viewer, if you use the viewer, like the main viewer, it will actually show the title and subtitle when you use this brackets. Otherwise it will not. Then there's the thumbnail. So the thumbnail is basically what you see in here and as well in the publish right over here. And as well, when you create in this in skin a thumbnail viewer, then you will see it here as well. So this image can be changed when you change it right over here with this blue folder icon. Then the scene viewer, well, we mentioned that. So then what you have is the thumbnail mode. By default, it's set to Mosaic. This only changes this little thumbnail. So you can say this is going to be the first photo. If I change it like this, and I change it here, and change it back to single again, it will take the first one again. I can also say collage, like that. So, and then you have the single, where you just take this photo. Then what you can do, and what is quite important to look at, is how everything is scaled. So the photos right now, it's set to fit outside. I can also say there's no scaling. And as you can see, I'm zoomed in much more because the resolution of this photo is much higher. So I would probably keep this to fit to outside, but sometimes, you know, fit to width might be better for landscape images, and fit to height might be better for portrait images. So these are things to play around with to make it work for you. Then you have the duration, so how long a photo is going to be viewed. For by default it's on 3-5 seconds, but let's say it's going to be 2 seconds. 1, 2, 2, 2, and so on. Then you have the key burns, the Ken Burns effect. The Ken Burns effect is basically the zoom that you every time pan somewhere. This can be set with the easing. You can play around with how it like is. It's animated basically. So you have linear, but you can also say something like cubic in. Preview. And it goes more like vroom. So the trends like whoom, you got a whoom instead of like linear. So you can play around with that. Then you have to zoom in, or you can zoom out on photos. And you can see it zooms out on every photo now. Then you have the offset, and I have actually no idea how it really works. If you do know, let me know in the comments in the video. What I see that it's doing, that it has to do when you put it on a higher percentage, it will zoom more, and when you put it on a lower percentage, it will barely zoom in or out. So I think it's that, but I'm not too sure about it. And then you have the panning. So let's turn this off and see what's going to happen. Godverdomme. So actually, I have no idea what the offset is going to do. I have noticed that when I put this to a 100%, that it will use more zoom effects, and when you put it to 2%, it will not. But still, I really don't really get it too well. With the panning, it zooms kind of like also in a little bit more to the left or right, as you can see. When you turn this off, then basically it will only zoom in or out at the center of the photo album. So as you can see, the center of the photo album. Then what we have are the album actions. Add action, open panorama, reception. So at the end of the photo album, when it reaches the last photo and it goes to then the photo album is finished, then you can add an action to say, for example, open this panorama, or any other things like showing, hiding components, executing JavaScript, whatever. But everything is with at start and at end. So for example, JavaScript as well, on start, at end. And then you can add album audio, which is going to play music as you go through, as you see the photo album. Then what we still have are photo settings. We can put a name here and a description, but as far as I know, you cannot really use them anyhow. Like you cannot take them and then show them within the skin or something like that. Then you can change the thumbnails of the photos as well. So maybe they need like an icon or something, like this is a photo. You could put an icon here as well and put that through Photoshop as a custom thumbnail. Then the scale mode is fit outside, so you can change that individually for each photo. And the duration you can change for photos individually as well. So 5 seconds, maybe one should be 2 or the other should be 10. And so, well, all these things, they are like, well, they say what they have to do. And the quality by default is set to 75. What I would suggest is keep the quality as high as possible and compress everything after exporting the tour. So when you publish and then you have this web mobile selected, then you can use stuff like JPEG Mini Pro or these kind of compressors to reduce the size of these images in your virtual tour. How that exactly goes, I still have to figure out, and as soon as I do know, I'll make a tutorial about that. And then you can change the background music accordingly to the photo. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it and that you've learned something. If you have learned something, just give this video a like. So, well, see you in the next video.